if you were to click in your syllabus under day one onto the well-formed document workflow module, we're going to scroll down to the bottom of the page here and take a look at this example project workflow. This is, and if anyone needs that link, please let me know. I can just actually post it right here. And we're going to go right to the bottom of that page as a little graphic. So this is a brief overview of how we would expect all these projects to go, assuming you're starting with a raw manuscript from an author. So we're starting here at the top left. You receive your raw manuscript from the author. You'll vet it. I'll also discuss vetting. We'll take a look at image requirements. And then when it gets into the process, we're going to structure all the different styles according to the HTML list. Images are going to get stripped out and replaced with callouts for images. But graphics aren't preserved as you convert it from one form to another. So those we just sort of replace with a like place figure here, figure one here. That gets placed actually by the typesetter. Or if you're going from, let's say, Word to EPUB, your the hub will handle placing that image asset into the ebook, into the HTML. We determine whether equations can be text or images. So some very simple linear equations can be used with our styles. Other far more complex things maybe need to be treated as an image in order to preserve their appearance from Word to typesetting to EPUB. Once that's correct, once all the style, the document is structured, then you just go through your normal editing process. You can use our tools. You can, here we have like an example of Word comments, editing in Word. We just want to make sure that any changes you make in editing get changed to that actual composed manuscript file. Again, you want to make sure that all the styles are preserved. So if you find something supposed to be italic in editing, you want to make sure that it gets that I tag. The final manuscript goes to the hub. You can see those little gear icons all mean contact with the hub. So that manuscript that's been composed and edited, ready for typesetting, gets converted to a file type called IDTT. It's a basic InDesign tag text file. So it has all those styles, all the stuff is tagged. It has the list of styles that then get loaded into your InDesign template. You typeset in a way according to our workflow, making sure that you're not introducing problems. We'll discuss that a lot more in actual typesetting. Once the typeset is complete, it's been indexed, it's ready to go to print, then we start working on the electronic version of the book. This could be an EPUB, this could be HTML. But what we do is, using those Scribe tools I just discussed, we're loading our style list, tagging text according to those styles. That's all done automatically using the tools. We're inserting page IDs for linking. Again, that's all automatic. And then it gets processed to the hub. The hub can output a SAM file. We'll check that. You'll convert that to an HTML file. Start adding in your linking attributes as you need. Start working on maybe different accessibility information, working on IDing things. And then once that HTML file is correct, it goes back into the hub again. It can turn into an electronic publication like an EPUB or a Kindle file, or it can get turned into HTML. Let's say your author wants it again for a second edition, or you want to edit it, or you need a Word file of it with all those corrections you made in typesetting. Well, because you've extracted it right from typesetting, you're not going back to that source manuscript and correcting it. You can just extract text from InDesign, convert it onto the hub, and then output this like new edited Word document that has the final version of the text. So there's a couple different versions of it, and then once it goes back into Word, it basically, you would draw a line to just reconnect it back to the start of it if you're, let's say, printing a second edition of your book. Going back through, well, with the exception of composing it, because it'll already be composed and have all the styles applied to it. And that's what we refer to as round tripping. So if you were to round trip a project, it'd be done through production, come out as a Word document again, and then it's ready for, round two, essentially, ready for a second edition.
What I think I'm hearing is that the hub will handle auto-paging fairly easily, but once you've gotten an auto-paged file, can you go back and make corrections and go back into the hub without having a problem with the file?
Yes, essentially. So we use a combination of our styles and InDesign technologies to handle paging automatically. You can identify different aspects, like your chapter numbers are always going to start with a new page, let's say, or a new recto reverso page. So So in InDesign, when we get into the design aspect, we'll talk about setting up your templates in such a way that that rule is maintained. Now, the types that are still going to check for bad breaks, things like that, we have a in that IDTT file I mentioned, it inserts a lot of different break characters to help for normal things like, you know, making sure your ellipses aren't broken in half or making sure you're not breaking on the wrong side of a M dash or N dash. But then what we do is we do that extraction at the end of the typesetting process. It doesn't affect your main typesetting file. Yeah, float and sync. So there is a tool that we use to, let's say, change the sync of a chapter opener page or a different type of page. I may be getting slightly off track, but to answer your original question, the hub wouldn't necessarily handle float and sync and paging. We're going to handle that with a combination of styles and your InDesign template, but that's going to handle a lot of work there. And then the images, things like that, can be placed automatically, can be placed manually. We do have a tool in those Scribe tools that helps with image placement. And again, they all get turned into callouts later. So when it goes to the electronic version, that's all handled by the hub, actually. Is that answering your question? Yes. Okay, cool. Yeah, there'll be a lot of different combinations that we discuss when we get into production. So it's like the hub does a little bit of this, the InDesign tools do a little bit of this, and the typesetter does the rest of it, essentially. So let's see. I think that's it. Does anyone else have any general questions about the workflow, about any stage in the workflow or any of the tools that we're going to be using?